job, boy. Good robot. Now go on over there and clean like you're supposed to. You did good. You should. Next time we're gonna teach you how to open it. No, boy. Where you going with that? Come back here. They may all yours? No. None of that. Let's make an Italian beef hoboy, a sandwich, like what they have up there in Chicago. Yeah. Here's the stuff you're going to need. Some kind of hoboy looking bread, bell peppers, garlic, thyme, oregano, dry wine, salt and pepper, beef roast, roast beasts, and Gardendina, or however you say it up there. Down here we call it Italian olive salad. And this stuff is heavy in garlic. And it's what we put on muffalettas. You can also say it muffalata. There's two spellings of it. And I made it before. And the muffalata, how you call it, lotta. I don't think I've ever did an Italian beef before. Normally, you would do this with a how you call it, roast, a sirloin, tip roast. And you apply the seasonings on it, and then bake it in the oven until it's rare. And you got a nice crust on the outside. But I'm going to do it in a pot, because I know better. And we'll go from here. Let me mention that doing it in the oven with a sirloin, you got to slice it paper thin and then put it in your gravy. But I'm going to do it all in gravy. And really, this is going to end up like a shredded beef. Well, it don't matter whether it's sliced or shredded. This is a shoulder roast. It's boneless. This is very similar to our Cajun pot roast that we have down here that I've made many, many, many times. Mom's pot roast, however you want to call it. Let me wash my hands first. Or even a New Orleans debris po'boy. So, apply salt heavily. That ain't near enough. Put some pepper on. Heavily. Let me get a container of salt. Let me just open this son of a bitch. My hands are wet because I just washed them. Hold up. Yeah, I didn't think I'd be able to open that slippery thing. It kind of jams because salt gets stuck in the groove. Come on loose, boy. That side. Get some thyme on here. Get some oregano on here. Pat that in. Let's dump some Earl. Can you see this way, boy? Look. Let's dump us some oil. Yeah, use motor oil, see what it tastes like. This is vegetable oil. You can use olive oil if you want. I don't care. Not sure how. Never mind. Now let's season the other side of it also. I should have put that on the fire. It don't matter. We'll season the other side of it and brown this, and I ain't cutting no fat off yet. Other side of it is seasoned. It's in the pan. I'm going to get a nice color on this roast. And once you got a pretty brown color on there, like what you see on all sides, go ahead and remove the roast. Put it in the top But a pan, you're gonna put the pot top. Yeah, the lobster top, right, good. A whole onion. Just rough chop up in there. It's gonna release a little bit of liquid and start to deglaze that pan somewhat. But we're gonna help it out. Give him 1 second or two. I don't have to fire up real high. I didn't want to burn all that down at the bottom. If your grease is splattering and popping all over the place, your fire's too hot. Cut it back a little bit. You don't want blacken this, but you want a nice brown on it. Same way on your roast over there. Got them onions are browning, but releasing that brown off the bottom from the liquid coming out of them. Give them just a few minutes, not many. I want your onions to wilt it down for about 2 minutes. Dump in your bell peppers. Rough chop also. It's going to cook for a while. And see how them onions done released all that brown off the bottom of that pan? Give them bell peppers a little bit of time. Son of a bitch. Stupid camera. I dumped in a cup of red wine, and I just moved it off with a small burner that I like to brown the meat and veggies on, and I'm putting it over a larger burner because it got a larger surface area. This is a larger pot. Dumbass camera. Yeah, so let's get some garlic in there now. Oh, don't let that wine boil. You let it simmer, but don't let it boil. You get it, make it bitter. You record stupid? Good. I got about a half a head of garlic. Just smashed up with my meat hammer. Y'all know how to do that. You don't gotta chop it fine. Put that in there. Use a whole head if you got it. That was all I had. Get that all down up underneath that wine. We're gonna have to add some water. Got some hot water. We're gonna cover the meat, or at least just bring it up to the top like that. Then cover the pot. Get this up to simmering. And go get another pop and let that cook for a couple hours. Now you done took my bud dry. My last bud dry. You loco robot. I told you not to drink all that shit. Look how he just running around in a circle like that. He don't know what he's doing. You drunk, boy. Stupid robot. Give me that beer. Add you a couple of these little beef-flavored cow licks in there. While you're at it. Bullion cubes, boy. The salt. That's going to add some salt to that gravy. It's going to need it. And while y'all wasn't paying attention, I stuck a few carrots and a few potatoes in that Italian beef. So let's make some pancakes with these. Yum. So take you a fork. Something like that, and just kind of mash these up. These are taters. They've been cooked in that beef. Take a cackle fruit, pop him open, dump him in something where you can worry it. And them potatoes already been seasoned. Look, over here, boy. Let's dump some of this cackle fruit in there. All of it. The whole cackle fruit. Now, whisk that all around. And let's go fry that off. Yum. See right there? Oh, you're recording this time, huh? Put you some Earl in there. Get the Earl wormed up. Yeah, there you go. How you call it? Like that. Then dump you in a little potato dumpling. See, like that? There's another one. Who cares what they look like? You just worry about how it's gonna get in your mouth. Yum. So we got these little tater pancakes. Uh-oh. They wanted to fall apart. I know why. I forgot to put flour in them. Oh well, they good like that. Now, more Earl in the pan. Italian beef. My way. Mm-hmm. See right there? Put that in the pan. Let's get it crisped up a little bit. I see some more. Crisp them up too. See right over there? It's already falling apart. Yum. Meanwhile, I'm gonna eat another one of these little yums. Them are good. Now there's so much going on with the hurricane. I got a piece of French bread. Look down here. Don't get in there. Get some of that gravy on that. Both sides. See like that right there? Now you want to get some of that stuff out of that. See the stuff right here? That's them little pieces of garlics and all them onions. Put all that on there, man. Yum. See all that good stuff like that there? Put all that on there. All on there. And got some potato fritters. We'll set them on the side, just for good measure. I decided to fry some of this beef. Yum. Let's go ahead and put us some carrot sticks on there like that. And see this crispy looking beef? How do that look? Let's give us some of this olive mix. Like that. Garlic olive mix. Yum. As you look down there, boy. Pictures needed, huh? And where you think you going? You about dumb as your brother. Bring that back here, boy. Y'all pay attention. You about non-union. Some bitch.